This week's Mobile Mix comes to you from Huawei's glitzy smartphone unveiling in London, where the company unveiled its latest lineup of premium devices as part of an ongoing desire to become a dominant smartphone player.
With the build-up promising a higher intelligence, Huawei's Richard Yu wasted little time in unveiling the Mate 20 and Mate 20 Pro devices at a packed affair at London's Excel Centre. Yu was bullish throughout about the new lineup, hailing the power, efficiency and intelligence of the devices. And the company will take heart from analysts' reaction, with market watchers stating that this is the surest sign yet that the ambitious Chinese vendor has cemented its place alongside long-term dominant players Apple and Samsung. Indeed, the flagship Mate 20 Pro, powered by its Kirin 980 processor and priced at a punchy €1,049, now the norm price for a premium smartphone, certainly stands up in terms of specs as a major rival to Apple's iPhone XS line and Samsung's Galaxy Note 9. And Huawei knows it. Yu proceeded to stack up a list of comparisons with the rival devices and how the Mate 20 Pro trumps them, whether it was on battery life, screen-to-body ratio, or its devices simply being quicker to launch apps and respond to commands. Onto the camera, the Mate series, like its sister P20 device, goes one better than the dual camera, packing a free camera system on the rear of the device, enabling all sorts of snazzy AI-powered shooting modes, with the capability of identifying human form and recognize and process 4,500 images a minute. A higher intelligence, indeed. When it comes to new features, we certainly cannot accuse Huawei of lacking ambition or innovation, with manufacturers often slammed for introducing only incremental upgrades to new smartphones. The company certainly pulled some gems out of the bag, with reverse charge, the capability of using the back of the Mate 20 Pro device to charge other devices, such as the iPhone XS, one of the biggest headline grabbers. The device also has 3D facial scanning and a touch fingerprint scanner embedded on the actual screen, as well as nano capabilities, a lightning speed charge, a hidden speaker located in the USB-C port, and gesture navigation. Introducing a bit of fun to the presentation, a demo also showed off the phone's AR capabilities as it brought to life a toy panda to pose with you on stage. And with the event coming to an end, he saved the biggest for last, unveiling the 7.2-inch Mate 20X device, a phone positioned largely at gamers to rival the Nintendo Switch, generating huge applause from the audience. With a new smartwatch, the Huawei Watch GT, and the luxury Porsche design Mate RS smartphones completing the new lineup, Huawei has upped its game significantly and forced its main rivals to take notice.
Founded in 2016, the Telecom Infra Project, a Facebook-backed group, has been looking at new ways and new approaches to infrastructure in collaboration with operators and other tech companies. Well, this week, TIP held its major summit just next door. Justin has all the details.
It's only the third annual TIP event, but this is a fast-growing show with a bit of an alternative vibe. It's got big backing from Facebook, as the online giant continues its mission to connect the half of the world's population which remains offline.
This was a cool-looking show. It wasn't a sterile exhibition hall, and the 1,000 or so attendees were grateful for the fast Wi-Fi and the free all-day snacks. But when it came down to actual business, did the TIP Summit deliver? Well, certainly the message from TIP's operator backers was clear. The telecom equipment market needs to step up innovation. It is time for a new approach. It was telling that there was no speaker representation from Ericsson or Huawei during the two-day conference, although Nokia is working with the group and is a member. Instead, we heard how operators such as Telefonica and Vodafone are working on a new style of mobile networks, dubbed Open RAN, alongside lesser-known equipment suppliers such as Altiostar, Mavenir, and Parallel Wireless. And as the mobile industry marches towards 5G, TIP's biggest backer Facebook is pushing its own ways of providing operators with super-fast data services. Its TerraGraph initiative uses unlicensed millimeter wave spectrum to boost coverage in urban areas. Facebook highlighted trial deployments with Germany's Deutsche Telekom, Indonesia's XL Axiata, and Malaysia's YTL. Tellingly, all three operators gave impressive feedback on the technology and aim to launch more deployments. Away from urban initiatives, Facebook's head of engineering and infrastructure talked up work with Telefonica to bring connectivity to more than 25,000 Peruvians, while Facebook also plans to conduct trials of rural 3G and 4G deployments in a number of African countries. Facebook clearly wants to be an operator's friend. The big question now, though, is whether its TIP initiative, backed by more than 500 companies, can deliver on the large and broad number of projects it has established.
It's results season again, and one of the first to report was Swedish vendor Ericsson. Following a long period of struggles, the company's bottom line was boosted as it reaped the rewards of cost-cutting and the looming launch of 5G in North America, helping it to turn a profit for Q3. However, there was somewhat of a cloud over the news, with the vendor warning it may face punishment from US authorities following a long-running investigation into the company's business ethics. Meanwhile, Google said it is taking steps to avoid punishment and ward off potential fines. The internet giant confirmed it will now stop bundling pre-installed apps with its Android platform and instead charge manufacturers a fee to license its apps. The move comes after the company was hit with a $4.3 billion fine this year after the EC found it had abused the dominant position of its Android platform.
So that's it for this week's Mobile Mix. Next week we go to Berlin, where Steve will be at Broadband World Forum and I will be at Sigfox Connect. We will see you then.